In the year 2011, a battle of epic proportions was brewing, one that left teachers quivering in their loafers. Two parties, the PC and the paperback, fought to claim their place in society. But when did this duel begin? This rivalry can date back to over 100 years.
1901, first radio transmitter. 1910, first gas-powered manor. 1921, first motorized steam. 1940, color TV. 1946, computer parts. 1967, handheld. 1958, computer motor. 1968, first CR. 1979, cell phones. 1981, IWC. 2001,
as technology advanced, it replaced contemporary means of receiving and providing information. As a result, the traditional education systems are going to need to adapt to accommodate these new mediums.
Technology is a fabulous thing, but there are some downsides to technology. I feel that socially, technology is almost eroding our ability to think. We're no longer able to pick up on body language cues as well. It's just becoming different. It's more of a electronic form of communication.
You know, the kids, they're born right into this technological world. For us, born a little bit earlier, we sort of grew with the technology. We saw it evolve, we saw its progress.
Establishments and even businesses have been adapting by trying to make technology a part of their module, really, and it's making it more accessible for everyone.
As a matter of fact, in 2004, 699.9 out of every 1,000 Canadians had a personal computer. In 2005, 513.9 out of every 1,000 Canadians subscribed to a mobile phone. In 2003, 99% of Canadian households owned a television.
Technology has affected the way we learn, and it's made it easier for us to access school information.
Well, you know, when you look at education, it's a very dynamic profession. You have this special interaction between student and teacher.
While I feel that technology definitely has its high points, it's increasing productivity, it's great for allowing us to access information quickly, I feel at the same time it's also hindering our ability to evolve or expand socially.
Today, children are quickly introduced to technology and are exposed to it often. The increased use of technology by the youth forces us to ask the question, how is the classic school system going to keep up with the high-speed, fast-paced technological world in which students are living?
Well, one way to teach this new wired generation is to embrace technology, and including classrooms. You know, you have programs like Top Hat Monocle and iClickers and Smart Boards, which were developed especially for classroom use, and that's one way that teachers can really get their students motivated and involved with the use of technology.
We'll have professors who upload their PowerPoint presentations online and upload their notes so we can follow along, we can download them so we can access them from anywhere we want, really.
And another option for teaching this newer generation is perhaps encouraging the traditional and classical way of learning.
When I talk about classical, I'm thinking textbooks and actual books, hands-on reading, the teacher in front of students, those social interactions and the core social elements of those teaching styles are what is going to help preserve some of the major aspects of our society.
The solution to the problem might not be crystal clear. While technology provides access to information at a rate far beyond other mediums, it neglects to provide some of the benefits that we see through classical teaching methods.
I don't think we should disregard these classical teaching methods just because we have a generation that's so plugged in.
People shouldn't see technology as a replacement. They should use it more as an aid or a resource to help with the process of learning. If we were to replace everything with technology or with machines, where would we stand? What happens to humans?
In the end, will this duel come to a finish? Or perhaps even end in a draw? Maybe the best answer is still to be discovered by future educators.